हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू नाहर ग्लोबल स्कूल द आईटी क्लास फॉर क्लास 10th. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द पार्ट ए, एम्प्लॉयबिलिटी स्किल्स फॉर इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी सिलेबस ऑफ क्लास 10th. इट कवर्स कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स, सेल्फ मैनेजमेंट स्किल्स, बेसिक आईसीटी स्किल्स, entrepreneurial skills and green skills. Let us start with the communication skills. The first things which comes into our mind when we hear the word communication is, what exactly is the meaning of communication? What is communication? Exchange of information by signs and signals, speaking, writing or using some other medium and means is called as communication. Whatever medium you are using to speak or to write something, or if you want to convey your thoughts to something, then all these will be called as the means of communication. Now, what are the learning objectives for effective communication? Sending, receiving and understanding the message or information should be efficient. Development of interpersonal skills plays a very important role in communication. To express effectively with maximum efficiency is the main objective of effective communication. Now let us come to communication cycle. What is the process of communication? Communication cycle is the process by which a message is sent by one individual and it passes through a chain of recipients. The recipients are the people who are receiving the message. The timing and effectiveness of communication cycle is based on how long it takes for feedback to be received by the initial sender. You will be able to understand it through this diagram. First of all, the sender communicates and sends a message to receiver. The receiver, after getting the message, sends the feedback to the sender. The less the time for this process, the more efficient or effective is the communication. So this is the effective communication cycle. Now, what are the elements of communication in this? Sender or communicator, who sends the message. Receiver, who receives the message itself. Communication channel, through which the medium of communication through which you are sending the message. And the feedback or response plays a very vital role in communication. Now, who is the sender? We have already discussed. It is the person who just originates the communication. Message is the information that the sender wishes to convey. Channel is the mean by which the message is sent. And coding is the sender. How the sender is choosing to bring the message into the form which is appropriate for the sender for sending the message. Receiver is the person who is getting the message. Decoding is how the receiver is interpreting, how it is, he is understanding the message. And feedback is the response of the message by the receiver. Now, what are the styles of communication? There are four main categories of communication styles. Whenever we are in classroom, first of all, we can communicate verbally. Verbal communication is the use of language to transfer or share information through speaking or sign language. You can speak up or you can use the sign language. Then second is non-verbal communication, where body language, gestures and facial expressions are used. You will be able to understand through this photograph. Here you can see that people are expressing their thoughts and feelings through their hands and gestures along with facial expressions. Then comes the visual. Visual communication is the act of using photographs, videos, art, drawing, sketches, charts and graphs to convey the information. Here you can see that whenever you are attending a smart class in your school or anywhere else for understanding anything, then here you are getting the visuals which are very easy to understand, and they are used for visual communication. This photograph will make it more clear to you. Then we are coming to written communication. Written communication is the act of writing it down, or typing or printing symbols like letters or numbers to convey some information. It is helpful because it provides a record of information for future reference. So you can write it down, write the things down and send it to the sender, and the sender can send it and receiver will receive it to understand what message has been given. Now, what are the advantages of written communication? This is very important thing. What are the advantages of written communication? The first advantage is permanent record. You can keep a record of the written communication. The notation that the written document is a permanent record and it fulfills all the prerequisites for getting the information. So it is having this advantage. Now next is easy circulation. You can circulate the written document to as many people as you want. Suitable for statistical data. You can compare the data through graphs or other data handling techniques. Then we have, it promotes goodwill when conducting a business. Whenever you are sending the written documents, it speaks volumes. Like it is very efficient and it is very competent for an organization. Now what are the disadvantages? It takes a lot of time consuming. It is non-flexible. You are not able to change it. You cannot clarify it. Writing for proficiency should be there. You should be very well versed in the language which you are using. Then there may be the probability of wrong interpretation. Written words may not express your feelings that effectively. So these are the disadvantages. What are the advantages of verbal communication? It saves a lot of time. It takes less time. It saves your money also, because you do not require the papers and other things for sending the messages. Then feedback is very quick. Whenever you are speaking something, you get the feedback more quick. You receive a feedback quicker as compared to the written communication. It is very convenient, obviously. When you are speaking something, it is very convenient to convey your thoughts or feelings. And ease of preparation, it is very easy to verbally communicate as compared to writing it down. So these are the risks of verbal communication. Now there are some disadvantages also. First is chances of distortion in meaning. Due to some barriers, when you are sending the message, there may be some barriers in the sending that can cause the distortion in the meaning. For example, if you are speaking through the mobile phone, then there may be some problem of the network also. It is not convenient for long messages. You cannot send long messages whenever you are communicating verbally. You can forget a few things also. Writing it down is easier for long messages. Irrelevant information can be passed. When you are speaking, you speak in a flow. Maybe you can give some irrelevant, which is not important, that kind of information also. Misunderstanding can be there. Usually when two individuals are having the conversation, they can have some misunderstanding. They can get into some verbal discussions which can lead to some fights also. That can happen. That happens. You can argue also. Some kind of arguments are also there. Communication cost again is there. when verbal communication is done, sometimes it gets expensive also, depending on the technology which you are using. So we have the advantages of written communication, disadvantages of written communication, advantages of verbal communication, and disadvantages of verbal communication. All these things are there.